Well, good morning. I guess there's good news and bad news. The good news is my car no longer beeps while I first start driving in the morning. Never mind. I totally made that up. I swear, it didn't do that. The last couple of days, as soon as I said it, it did it. That's hilarious. Okay, so never mind. No good news or bad news. It does it still. I was going to say the bad news is that it doesn't warn me to put my seatbelt on, which is not good because that's usually the only thing that makes me put my seatbelt on. And it's not extremely tight. It does kind of cut into it if I allow it to. Anyway, as you can see, I'm leaving the storage facility. You may be asking why. Why are you in a storage facility? What's going on? Today is December 4th, 2017. I think it's Kira's birthday, actually. Anyway, Kira, my friend, my best friend, was so kind and generous. She loaned me her storage unit. And I put all my stuff in her storage unit. And I haven't told my husband yet because I really don't want to admit to him how much stuff I really have. Even though he's been living with it for the last 12 years, it's not like I've been hiding my stuff. But now that it's all cleaned up, he never asked me where I put it all. Well, honey, it's in Kira's storage locker. And I haven't had to pay anything to borrow her storage locker. So I need to get it out before the end of January. Here's my goal. My goal is to spend as much time in the mornings before work and as much time in the evenings after work sorting through my stuff. I've got all kinds of stuff. I've got school supplies. I've got art supplies. I've got stickers. I guess that's an art supply. I've got papers the kids drew on. I've got important papers and not so important papers. I've got memories and photos and business cards and magazine clippings and envelopes and cardstock and more cardstock and pattern paper and stamps and inks and markers and pens and pencils, and I could go on. I just have lots of stuff. Now, when I borrowed the storage unit from my friend Kira, it was my intention to get rid of everything and only keep the actual stuff that I could use, right? That I know I will use, that I know I will go through, and not just, oh, I should someday, but the actual stuff I know I will use. And I realized that the only reason why I'm not into my crafts is because I haven't been able to get to it. The reason why I haven't been able to get to it is because I don't have any place to store it other than a bin. And I don't like storing it in a bin because I can't get to it. So I feel like I'm not into my crafts anymore because I'm not doing them. So I wonder if I really want to get rid of them or if I just need to find a better way to store everything. So I tried talking to my husband about this the other day, and he was helpful and gave some pointers, but I still don't know what I want. I still don't know how I want to organize it. I still don't know how I want to display it. I still don't know what's the best solution. I still don't know anything. So the goal right now is to just get through it. Get through my stuff, dwindle it down. Maybe it'll make it easier. If I spend a few minutes in the morning and a few minutes every evening, every day, 5 days a week, for the next 4 weeks, I should really be onto something. And it's not overwhelming. And I'm not getting too tired, and I'm not getting too burnt out on it, I don't think. Now, here's the thing. You might be wondering, well, what about working out? Well, let me tell you something that's interesting about the universe. I hurt my hand at work last week, a week from today, a week ago today, and I haven't really been able to use my thumb too well. And I tried working out 3 times since I hurt my thumb, Monday night, Tuesday night, and Thursday night. And it seems like to me, the more days that passed, the worse it felt trying to grip, right? The machines and everything. So Thursday was my last time working out, November 30th, and I'm thinking to myself, it's really hard. It's really hard to work out with my thumb being hurt this bad. I'm not going to say that my thumb's going to hurt forever, because I did go to the doctor about it on Friday, and the doctor, workers' comp, is who's taking care of this injury, you know, treatment and stuff. But the doctor said that I could continue work as normal, just to ice it and heat it, and it'll get better, right? Ibuprofen for the pain. But I don't think they knew that it was having longer lasting effects, and it kind of concerns me that it is. So anyway, I don't know, the bruising is gone. I don't feel that anymore. That's exciting. That means I can hold a pencil again and stuff. But if I grip something, like I hold on to something, like I was holding my daughter's brush last night and brushing her hair, that really hurt everywhere. So anyway, it might be a carpal tunnel thing. It might be a pinched nerve. I don't know what it is, but I am not able to work out for a little while, but I can pick up paper clips and erasers and stamps and papers, and I can go through things like I'm some wonderful angel person, right? Getting my shit cleaned out. My therapist told me on Friday that I need to stop focusing on my relationship. It's not healthy for me, obviously. I need to be focusing on other things. And focusing on my clutter usually overwhelms me and frustrates me and puts me in an anxiety mode, and I don't like thinking about that either. However, I have a game plan. I have a place where all my stuff is nice and laid out. I've got a table. I've got some baskets. I'm recycling or trashing or donating or selling or keeping it, and gonna have a place for it when I get home. That's the goal. So I am going through things for the first time in forever, in years. I did go through things when my sister Megan was in town 3 years ago, 3.5 years ago. I went through things and I got rid of things, but it was probably only like 1 or 2 bins compared to the 8 or 9 that I have of things I need to go through. So I'm just going through things little by little, years and years and years worth of clutter that I've kept, and I'm tired of keeping, and I'm focusing on it. And by focusing on it, it distracts me from my relationship issues. Helps me minimize the relationship issues enough to get through the holidays, right? I've also got a second job where I'll be doing the samples at the grocery store. I'm not sure I told you guys about that. Anyways, the samples at the grocery store job pays $75, and it's for 5 hours, and that basically means it's $15 an hour. However, like any job, your $15 an hour doesn't cover taxes, right? You still gotta pay taxes. So even though I'm going to get the full $15 an hour because they're not going to take my taxes out, I've got to make sure I pay those taxes when tax time comes. The other thing is, so I'll be doing that on the weekends. That's what I was going to say. So Saturday and Sunday, I'm going to be busy. So I'm thinking to myself, well, I either got to take time off work or not do the second job on the weekends or work out in January. Don't work out in December. That's all I can say. That's all I can think of. Because if I work out in December, even just a little bit, that's time I could be using to go to the storage shed. And I still haven't told my husband about the storage shed, so as long as I don't take too long at the storage shed and just use that as my workout time, I'm standing, I'm exercising, I'm moving, but I'm just not gripping. You know what I mean? So give me time to maybe heal, I'm hoping. But it also is a productive time where I can get stuff sorted and not... And see, here's the thing. I've got such a dependent personality, codependent personality, that my husband, I need my husband's approval, I need my husband's blessing, I need my husband. So if I did tell him about it and he disapproved, I wouldn't have the motivation to get this stuff done, because I'd feel like I was disappointing him or not doing it the way he wants me to do it, or then I'd feel like my efforts are worth nothing because it's not my idea, it's his idea. That is my issue. That's my issue. That's my problem. So I'd rather not tell him and just be proud of myself in my own self without depending on him or anybody else to lift me up or make me feel good about it. So anyway, that's where I'm at. I'm in a pretty good mood, obviously. I don't necessarily know if it's going to last because I typically go into being in a good mood. So I just need to prepare myself for that possibility that crisis stuff might happen, but I just need to keep myself level-headed. Oh, and I'm not sure if I mentioned this, but I am on medication. I'm on Lexapro. So that's kind of that's kind of maybe why I'm in a good mood. It's only 10 milligrams. It's not as much as I was having before. So I really don't feel extremely different, but I do feel better. So that's where I'm at, folks. I'll talk to you all later. Oh, and by the way, my hair looks like this because I wore it back all day yesterday under a bandana. So yeah, it's not down yet, but does it look okay? Hopefully. All right, bye-bye.